Namaste. Welcome to the lecture series on the subject Applied Thermodynamics. This is Module 3, Vapor Power Cycles, Lecture Number 8. Myself, Dr. N. Satish Kumar, Associate Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Kendra Engineering College, Bantwal. So, we will continue to solve numericals on vapor power cycles. So, Number 6, a steam power station uses the following cycle. Steam at boiler outlet is 150 bar. Reheat at 40 bar to 50 degree C. Condenser pressure is 0.1 bar. Using Mollier chart and assuming that all processes are idle, find the quality at turbine exit or exhaust and cycle efficiency and the steam rate. So this is the Mollier chart diagram. So steam at boiler outlet is 150 bar. So this pressure, so 1 to 2, this line, so pressure is 150 bar. Reheat at 40 bar, so next it read up first stage expansion. So reheating means there are two stages of expansion. You should understand that. So first stage expansion is 2 to 3 and 3 to 4 is the reheat, which is taking place at 40 bar to a temperature of 550 degree Celsius. So now it is understood that even the temperature at 2 is also 550 degrees Celsius. The T2 is equal to T4. Okay, so reheated to original temperature, that's the meaning. Then it undergoes the expansion, that's 4 to 5 to 0.1 bar pressure. All the processes are ideal, that is 2 to 3 is isentropic, 4 to 5, even 3s also you can write here, or 5s also you can write like previous problem, but it is already written 3 and 5, so let me continue to use 3 and 5 only. Okay, so you have to find out quality of steam at turbine exhaust, cycle efficiency and the steam flow rate. So from the Mollier chart, at P2 is equal to 150 bar and temperature 550 degrees Celsius. Okay, sorry, this is just given data noted. P3 is 40 bar, T3 is 550 degrees Celsius, P5 is 0.1 bar. Now from Mollier chart, H2 is nothing but enthalpy value at 150 bar and 550 degrees Celsius. So this is 3450 kilojoules per kg, you can check the Mollier chart. And H4 is nothing but H value at 40 bar and 550 degrees Celsius, which comes around 3562 kilojoules per kg. Now to find out H3, so once you locate this point 2 on the Mollier chart, come down vertically downwards to intersect 40 bar line. You see, how did you locate point 2? 150 bar and the intersection of 550 degrees Celsius line. So 150 bar you have to go along that line till it intersects this 550. You see, this is the 550 degree line. So where it intersects, there is a point 2. Come down vertically downwards to intersect 40 bar. So that is point 3. So that is the value of H3. And now from H3 point, if you go along the 40 bar line till it intersects this 550 degrees Celsius line at 4. So that is nothing but your H4 value, which you have noted here. Now from 4, once again come down till it intersects 0.1 bar line at 0.5. So enthalpy at 5 is 2290 kilojoules per kg. And also note down which dryness fraction line passes through this 0.5. So there is a dryness fraction at that point, which is 0.876 kilojoules per kg. Now here the value of enthalpy at 0.6. So I was repeatedly telling this in previous problems also, it cannot be taken from the Mollier chart. So H6 cannot be determined from the HS diagram or the Mollier chart. So you have to use the steam table. So H6 is nothing but HF at 0.1 bar. So you'll get as 191.8 kilojoules per kg. And 6 to 1 is isentropic pump work, which is the formula WP is equal to V into integration of DP. So V is nothing but specific volume at 0.1 bar, VF. This is nothing but VF at 0.1 bar. This pressure difference is 150 minus 0.1 because this is 150 bar line, 6 is 0.1 bar line. In 10 to the power 5 to convert to Pascal, divided by 10 to the power 3 to convert into kilojoules. So you will get test 15.14 kilojoules per kg. So we'll get the pump work is equal to H1 minus H6, which is nothing but 15.14. So if you substitute for H6, you'll get H1 as 206.94 kilojoules per kg. So you see, this is how the molar chart, you see, very easily, quickly, you can note down the enthalpies at 2, 3, 4, 5, then the drainage fraction at 5. So H6 and H1 easily you can calculate using steam table and the pump work. Now, quality of the steam at the turbine exhaust. Now, the quality of the steam at the turbine exhaust, X5 is equal to 0.876. You noted it from the Muller chart. And you know the efficiency formula, eta efficiency for this eta cycle, WT minus WP divided by QH. So, your turbine work will have two turbines, that is HP turbine 2 to 3 and LP turbine 4 to 5. So, that is H2 minus H3 plus H4 minus H5. So if you substitute, you'll get as 1672 kilojoules per kg. And heat input also two terms it as, one is Q1 plus Q reheat. So 1 to 2 is the boiler heat addition in the boiler, which is Q1, so that is H2 minus H1. Reheat is from 3 to 4, that is nothing but H4 minus H3. After substitution, you will get it as 3755 kilojoules per kg. Now, substituting for eta cycle, so you'll get it as 44.12% and steam flow rate or specific steam consumption as 2.16 kg per kilowatt hour. So, to develop every kilowatt hour power, you have to supply 2.16 kg of steam. Or to develop 1 kilowatt power, you have to supply 2.16 kg per hour of steam. Okay. Now, next problem, steam at 50 bar 350 degrees Celsius expands to 12 bar in a HP stage and is dry saturated at the stage exit. This is now reheated to 280 degrees Celsius without any pressure drop. The reheat steam expands in an intermediate stage and again emerges dry and saturated at a low pressure to be reheated a second time to 280 degrees Celsius. Finally, the steam expands in LP stage to 0.05 bar. Assuming the work output is the same for the high and intermediate stages and the efficiencies of the high and low pressure stages are equal, find efficiency of the HP stage, pressure of steam at the exit of the intermediate stage, total power output from the three stages for a flow of 1 kg per second of steam, condition of steam at exit of LP stage, and efficiency of the reheat cycle. Also calculate the thermodynamic mean temperature of energy addition for the cycle. So, okay, very lengthy problem. Let me analyze this. So, steam at 50 bar and 350 degrees Celsius expands 12 bar in a HP stage. So, first turbine is HP turbine. The entry point is 50 bar and 350 degrees Celsius. Exit is at 12 bar. When it exits, it is dry saturated. This is reheated to 280 degrees Celsius, that is the second stage. So there is no pressure drop, means 12 bar itself. The reheat steam expands again in an intermediate stage and emerges dry saturated at low pressure. So second stage, at the end of the second stage also, it is dry saturated. Further reheated in the third stage, that is for the second time, it is reheated to 280 degrees Celsius and expands in the LP stage or third stage to 0.05 bar. So work output is same for high and intermediate stages, that is first two stages. Efficiencies of the high and low pressure stages are equal. High and low efficiencies are equal. So you have to find out what is the efficiency of the HP stage, pressure of steam at the exit of the intermediate stage. Intermediate stage pressure is not given. Okay. Then power output from the three stages for a flow of 1 kg per second, condition of steam at exit of LP stage, efficiency of the reheat cycle. Also you have to calculate the thermodynamic mean temperature of heat addition. Okay. So let us further analyzing using this HS diagram. So P1, this pressure, that is boiler pressure, is 50 bar and temperature at the entry of the HP turbine is 350 degrees Celsius. It expands to 12 bar, that is P2, that is 3S, 3,4, all same lines. And T4, temperature at 4 is 280 degrees Celsius after reheat. After the first stage, it is reheated to 280. And again, it is expands to P3, which is not known. And it is reheated again to 280, that is T6. and P4, that is final LP cylinder, LP turbine expansion takes place till condenser pressure of 0.05 bar. Now let us open the molar chart. So note down H2 at 50 bar and 350 degrees Celsius. I hope all of you can go through the table, chart. So H2 is equal to 3070, come down from 2 till it intersects the 12 bar line, note down H3S, right? And then also along the 12 bar line, go and meet saturation line, dry saturation line, because exit of the HP turbine is dry saturated. So 12 bar line and dry saturation line where it meets, note down H3, then go along that line till 280 degrees Celsius line. So you note down H4. So H2, H3S, H3 and H4 you can note down. To note down H6S or H5 or H6, so you don't know the pressure. So since you don't know the 0.6, so you cannot mark 0.7S or 7 also on the Mohler chart. Now let us use the calculate the efficiency for HP stage first. So HP turbine efficiency is nothing but H2 minus H3 is the actual expansion divided by isentropic expansion H2 minus H3S, so you will get it as 0.921. Now since the power output of the intermediate stage equals that of the HP stage, power output in the intermediate stage is equal to HP stage, that is given. So it is given H2 minus H3 is equal to H4 minus H5. See, power output of the HP is H2 minus H3, intermediate stage is H4 minus H5. They are equal. Since already you noted H4 value, so you can find out what is H5 using this relationship. So very tricky question. Only thing is you need to analyze this very properly and proceed step by step. So you noted the value of H5 now. Now since state 5 is on the saturation line, we find from the Mohler diagram that chart is P3 is 2.6 bar. Now you see enthalpy 5 just now you noted. So that enthalpy line read here and make it to come horizontally from that to meet this saturation line so that it touches here, right? Now find out which pressure line passes through that point. So H5 is known. And you know that H5 is on the dry saturated line. So from the H5 you read that number here, but it is calculated from previous. Go horizontally to intersect the dry saturation line. Check out which pressure line passes through that point. So that is nothing but your P3, which is 2.6 bar. Okay. Now once you note down or find out pressure as 2.6 bar, so go along that line to find out H6 at 280 degrees Celsius. So H6 you will get as 3038 kilojoules per kg. Okay. And from 4 you come, okay, before that from 4 and 4 come down vertically to 2.6 bar line. So you will get 5 years also. Okay. There first you do that. From 4 come down vertically. Okay. To 5 years line. That is a 2.6 bar line to get the 0.5 years. Go along the 2.6 bar line till it intersects 280 degrees Celsius line, note down H6, come down vertically downwards, note down H76. So let me repeat this for your understanding once again. So you see already you calculated H5 from the previous slide. So from H5 point, you note the mark H5 here, come horizontally till it intersects the dry saturation line. So this is the point where it intersects the dry saturation line, because this is a dry saturation line. You see this line, this line is a dry saturation line. So at this point you check out what is P3, so that you will get as 2.6 bar. So mark that pressure line, you can use a pencil, dry, make it thick. Now from already you noted the 0.4, you located the 0.4, come down vertically to intersect this new pressure line, which is 2.6 bar. So that value of enthalpy at that point is H5S. Then go along the pressure line till it intersects 280 degrees Celsius, temperature is constant line. This is 280 degrees Celsius. So reheated is again 280. So that point is 6 and enthalpy at that point is H6. Then from 6, come down vertically downwards to meet the 0.05 bar line. Okay. So that is nothing but H7, 6. since eta t is same for HP and LP stages, so eta t of LP is H6 minus H7 divided by H6 minus H7. So that is same as the HP turbine efficiency 0.921. If you simplify, you will get as 2487 as 2420.93 kilojoules per kg. Now our job is to, you found out H7 right just now using the efficiency of the LP turbine formula. Now find out X7. So how do you find out? So H7.7 is in the two phase region. So H7 is nothing but HF7 plus X7 HFG7. So all these HF values, so they have to be noted at 0.05 bar. So you can go through the table at 0.05 bar, note down this HF and HFG value. So you can find out, since H7 is already noted from the Mohler chart, so you can note down X7, or you can calculate X7 as 0.941. Now total power output of the turbine is nothing but three stages of expansion, so 2 to 3, 4 to 5 and 6 to 7. So H2 minus H3 HP turbine, intermediate is H4 minus H5 and low pressure turbine is H6 minus H7. So if you substitute and simplify, you will get the total work output or turbine work output as 1197.07 kilojoules per kg, and total power output per kg of steam is 1197.07 kilowatts, since the steam flow rate is given as 1 kilojoules per second. So if you divide by 1 kilo, if you multiply by 1 kilojoules 1 kg per second for this power output, because power is equal to mass flow rate into W turbine, so mass flow rate is 1 kg per second into this W net is 1197.07, so you'll get it as 1197.07 kilowatt itself. Now at pressure 0.05 bar from steam tables, so note down the value of H8, which is nothing but HF at 0.05 bar, which comes around 137.8 kilojoules per kg. And to calculate the pump work, so it is V into integration of dp. So that is Vf at 0.05 bar into 50 minus 0.05. So directly you can multiply by 10 to the power 2 to write kilopascal, so that you'll get the answer in kilojoules per kg, which is also equal to H8 minus H1. Yes, pump work is Vdp, V integration dp, or V into Pb minus Pc. Here in this case it is P1 minus P4, which is also equal to H8 minus H1s. I think by this time you will be very much familiarized with this. So you can calculate H1s from that. Now the heat supplied is H2 minus H1s in the boiler, H4 minus H3 in the first reheat, H6 minus H5 in the second reheat. So if you substitute, you will get the total heat supplied as 3475.18 kilojoules per kg. So once again, I request all my students to verify the answer. Check for this correctness of the substitution and correctness of the answer, but the procedure is correct. So there is no mistake in the method and the procedure. Okay. Now you can calculate the W net as WT minus WP, and after substitution, you will get the net work output from the cycle or the plant is 1192.05 kilojoules per kg, and efficiency as 0.343 or 34.3%. Now to calculate the mean temperature of energy addition or heat addition, you can use this formula. Tm is equal to H2 minus H1s. So H2 minus H1s is nothing but the heat added in the boiler during, that's the main heat addition process. And during this process, the entropy change is S2 minus S1s, because you know that Q is equal to TdS. So there's a formula. Heat input is nothing but temperature into entropy change. So here T is nothing but Tm, okay, ds is nothing but S2 minus S1s in the denominator, so Q is nothing but the enthalpy change during the heat addition process. So if you substitute, you will get the mean temperature of heat addition as 492 Kelvin. Also you can calculate the specific steam consumption and you will get it as 3.02 kg per kilowatt hour. So with this I conclude this lecture number 8, okay. And I will continue to solve few more problems in the next lecture. Thank you.